Okay, welcome back to another chapter of this tutorial series. So we are continuing with adding details to the interior. So I'm going to create a copy of one of these cubes that we have edited the last episode. And I'm just going to change the scale a bit because what we are building now is going to be some sort of connecting piece between these two other cube constructions to the left and to the right. So I'm going to move this up. So I'm just scaling it down here a bit. Yeah, you don't have to be perfectly precise here. Just try to make it fit somehow in between them. And yes, it's starting to look okay. So I'm going to add another segment over here. And now I'm hitting the C key and converting it to an editable object. And I'm also going to rename it. And now I'm going into point mode and I will select these two points here in the center and move it up a bit. And now I'm just going to select this edge in the center and apply a bevel, give it some subdivisions. And this is really quickly giving us this rounded shape. I know that there are definitely better ways to do this, but honestly, this was just the fastest way and totally worked fine in this scenario. So I just quickly did it using this technique. Okay, I'm having a hard time to select this edge over there, so I am going out of the edge mode and just move it more to the center. I'm also scaling it down a little bit, so I'm going back into edge mode and yeah, got everything selected, and just apply another bevel over there. But yeah, feel free to design this in any way that you like. I just did it like this here. Now I'm just scaling it a little bit again, just so it's fitting a bit better. Okay, this is looking good. So let's add another MoGraph cloner, and we are going to type in the same 300 centimeters that these clones are going to be apart, and also create 6 copies so it fits and aligns with our pillars. And what I'm doing now is also moving them. So as you can see, they're kind of going up like stairs. I really liked how this looked, especially because later when we add our ceiling, I think it just connects quite nicely to our wavy ceiling that we're going to create. So I'm just going to rename this here, keeping it organized. And yeah, for this wall, I also just went and did some really quick edits. So here I'm just scaling it a little bit. I'm just trying to fit it better between our floor and our ceiling, and I prefer if it's not intersecting with the floor and with the ceiling, because we can get this really nice small shadow. I think it can be a nice detail. So I'm trying to get this here. OK, Okay, so I think this is looking good. So I'm creating a copy of my cube and adjusting the scale a little bit. And this is really all I'm going to do for this wall. So I'm trying to do a similar looking design like as we did to these pillars on the right. And yeah, for me, it looked totally fine. We just did this. And yeah, that's it for this wall. So now we can take a look at what we have currently. Okay, so I'm adding a bevel now inside this null object, so it's affecting all of our objects. And just in case you didn't know, you should always have at least a really tiny bevel on every object. So even if you think you have a surface that has a super hard edge, then technically it still has a slight bevel on it, even if it's not visible for your eye. But in 3D it really helps to add bevels everywhere, because it's going to look better. Just in case you didn't know, try it out, and I can guarantee you that your render is going to look better if you have bevels on every edge. Yes, but don't go crazy. Try to find a reasonable number. So yeah, I'm adding a plane now and changing the segments a little bit. And also try to make the plane roughly like a little bit bigger than our house. And now we're adding a bent deformer here. And now this is me trying to find the right rotation for this effector. This is probably not the most professional looking way, but I got it. So you can also just look down here what I have written there and just apply this to your file. But yeah, we're going to fit this to the parent. And I'm just editing the strength a little bit here, and I'm going to rotate it so it's a bit more symmetrical. Okay, this is looking good, I think. And what we want to do next is to create a copy in our backup null. And now I'm going to right click, hit current state to object. And now we can go into the polygon mode here, and then if we hit U and L, then we get to our loop selection tool. And now I'm trying to select some faces over here. This is working good. And now I'm going to extrude this selection downwards. So yeah, maybe like negative 30. Okay, and we want to first hide our original ceiling because we don't need it anymore. And we are going back to polygon mode, select all and hit reverse normals. So it should be looking like this. And now we are going to edit into a subdivision surface object so we can smooth this out. Yeah. And as you can see, it slowly starts to look like my reference image that I have created. So we are going to add a displacer below our plane, add a noise, and you can already see that it is doing something. So we are increasing the height and go to our shading, to our noise, and edit some settings. Yeah, I'm just trying to get something here that looks good. yeah, you can play around with this as long as you want. I think I'm happy with this. So let's take a look at it in the live viewer. Let it load. And yeah, there we can see how it's looking. So I'm not 100% happy yet. So I want to change this angle a bit so it's leaning forward, so it's kind of going into a similar direction as we did with these connectors between our pillars over here. So one thing I don't like is that I think it's a little bit too much to the right. So if you looked out of these cuts in our wall that's on the right, before you could see the like where our ceiling is ending, and I just moved it back a little bit here and now it's looking better. So I'm just changing the rotation a little bit more, trying to get more close to the image that I have originally created. And yeah, just try to make it look good. You don't have to try and make it exactly as I'm doing here. Now I'm just moving it back and forward a little bit because I'm just trying to have this wall that you can see here on the left to be a little bit behind one of these extrusions that we have made on our ceiling, because it's giving us a small but nice little shadow that I want. Yes, I think this is looking good. This is, yeah, what I mean, this small little shadow. And yeah, here at the front, it's also looking good. Okay. So let's rename this to ceiling and move it into our room null. We can delete the old one that I blocked out. And yes, I'm just giving our connecting cubes here a little bit more of this, yeah, how do I call it? Just, I'm trying to raise them up a little bit more here so that they are fitting better to our ceiling. And now we are finally getting our snow to look right. So I forgot something here. We have to go into our material, to our color map, and invert it. And as you can see, it finally starts to look like snow. So now I'm adding a plane because, yeah, since we just edited our snow, why not start with the ice? So I'm moving this plane to where our water is, and I'm going into point mode, and I think it's a little bit too many subdivisions. So let's undo our converting and go back and give it a little bit less subdivisions. And yes, this seems like something that is easier to work with. And now I'm just trying to get a nice shape here. So yes, I'm happy with this for now. So I'm adding this into a cloth surface and give it some thickness. Yeah, this is looking good. And we want to remove this subdivision over here. So yeah, now I'm trying to place it a bit. You don't have to be too precise with this because we are going to change this later a little bit. And now we are adding a composite material here, calling it ice and applying it on our object. So let's add a submaterial and a render region. So it's only rendering this part that we have to see. So I added these ice textures now, and I'm going to connect these as always, roughness to roughness, normal to normal, and this is the displacement. I'm just going to plug it into the bump. That's fine in this case. We are also going to set our grayscale textures to float. And we want to change this to a specular material. And now I'm just adding a transform node to all of these and change the scale to 0.6. We want to activate fake shadows and also enable round edges. So now we can drag the round edges node into our editor and connect it over here. And we are just going into these settings, set it to accurate and give it a radius of 1 centimeter. And yeah, this is good. So it's giving us a slight bevel. So I'm trying to find a better position for our ice object. And as you can see, it really changes the look of the material depending how much it is intersecting with the water or how much it is above our water. So I'm just going to make a render region over here and just saving my project. Okay, but this is fine for now. So let's start adding a basic material to our ceiling for now. So make a new material, call it ceiling, and of course apply it to our object. First I'm going to move down our eyes. So yeah, applying it over here. And I want to have a render region just on our ceiling. As you can see, this is one part of this image that takes the longest to render. There's a lot of noise going on there. So this definitely helps to see it faster. And I'm just going to edit some values here. So bringing down the index so we get less reflection. And I have added these two concrete textures over here, and I'm just connecting these. And we want to add a projection node, set it to box, and add a transform. Okay, I want to bring down this specular so it's less reflective to something like 0.6. And this is how we are going to start with our ceiling material. We are going to edit this later, but not in this episode. So I hope you enjoyed it, and let's go over to the next chapter.